1.4 million Florida felons wait for an answer that could impact their ability to vote. As our Capitol reporter Forrest Saunders found out today, state Supreme Court hearings is the latest battle in a war over Florida's civil rights.
While former felons celebrated the one-year anniversary of passing Amendment 4,
the first case on our docket,
lawyers at the Supreme Court debated its meaning, specifically these words.
Completion of all terms of sentence, which is why we're here.
GOP lawmakers used that excerpt to justify passing an amended bill last session, requiring ex-felons pay court-ordered financial obligations before getting voting rights back. Attorneys for the governor and legislature saying in court Amendment 4 always intended for that.
All terms of sentence is intended to capture everything that a judge puts in a sentencing order.
Attorneys for the ACLU and other civil rights groups saying the law is essentially a poll tax.
As long as the completion of sentence requires payment of legal financial obligations, that would violate the 14th Amendment.
Governor Ron DeSantis called for this Supreme Court review after the legislature's new law created a civil rights firestorm. The court's opinion won't change it, but could help sway a federal lawsuit in April challenging the financial requirements.
You guys have a few moments?
Civil rights groups saying on their way out of the Supreme Court, they're feeling confident in a federal court victory next year, even if justices don't see things their way.
Regardless of what the court says, it will not impact in the slightest our ongoing federal litigation that demonstrates that it is unconstitutional to deny someone the right to vote based on the inability to pay.
In Tallahassee, Forrest Saunders, ABC Action News.